Welcome everybody. Hang on, have I got this turned on right? Yeah, I got this turned on right. We're going through. Welcome everybody here to the Corsair Gaming Arena. I'm Tubby One. I'll be your host of the English live stream for our finals day. That's right, it's all coming to an end, but don't worry, there'll be more down the road as we're doing the Corsair Gaming Arena to get all the best of Southeast Asia together and compete for $2,000 USD. If the winner of the semifinals wins, you get 500. So it's not too shabby at all. Let's go to the game. That's what you came here for. So it was iDEAL going up against Signature Trust. This is our first cab off the rank today. And hopefully it'll be one of those amazing games that you'll just say, this is brilliant. That's what I'm hoping for. I don't know if I'm going to get what I'm hoping for, but we're going to find out. We've had some interesting Dota yesterday when we did this, and hopefully just interesting Dota today. And hey, it's Thailand. It's old Thailand right now. iDEAL versus Signature Trust. So no matter what, if you're from Thailand, you're a winner in this game. Maybe not the next game, because there is some real good quality Dota coming out from them. The Singapore Rejects versus SCT, they have been looking like the strongest team so far. At the same time, they only played basically one draft with a small modification in the second game. So it's one of these things where you go, okay, maybe we haven't had the biggest sample size to judge. So we're going to get some more samples today. Wisp, very early ban out against Signature Trust, taking up the Lina as well. Lina appeared in almost every single game yesterday. She's just so dynamic that it's difficult to pass her up. The bounty pickup as well is a bit of a problem one for teams that just know they're going to go brawling. He's also a nuisance. Not really as successful yesterday, but you can't blame a team for taking him out in the first two. That leaves Lashrak as the last ban out, and iDEAL go directly into the Queen of Pain. So they're looking instantly for that lane control and that good team fight power. And interesting to see the combo they go with that. The Winter Wyvern is then picked up by Signature Trust, a very early Wyvern pick. Normally you kind of think about waiting it out a little bit longer for him. Same with other cores. But hey, someone may have banned out the Shadow Fiend in the second phase. It's highly unlikely that someone would do such a thing. But they're going to pick it up anyway. So Shadow Fiend and Queen of Pain, which means we push the Queen of Pain either into an offlane or a safe lane role. I'm saying that because when you're running an SF, you need to basically... you can give him space on the safe lane, but he's got some good kill potential that's there, and the laning presence isn't really that great. So you're not going to like run an SF on the safe lane and say, I'm going to zone out the... I'm going to zone out the offlane. It doesn't happen with SF that way. But if you have someone like an Earthshaker rotating with Fissure, then you raise, and you can normally kill them in the mid. And because the distance is so small, that's why it's SFS killing potential there as opposed to just on the safe lane. Where Queen of Pain's able to blink, she's able to shadow strike. There's like so you got your slows, you got your positional change, you got your burst damage as well. Not that great in the early stages, but it's enough when you combine it. Why would you ban out the Earthshaker? I was actually waiting for iDEAL to pick up a Shaker, because he's so great to walk in, throw a Fissure down, and the SF just, like, kills them all. Like, that's the way it works. That's the way it happens. But yeah, this time around, not gonna happen. I'll have to use somebody else. They still don't know who, Trust can be playing in the mid, and that's where I thought that actually turned their attention to. Banning out the other mids that might cause issues for the SF. But banning out the Earthshaker and the Tuskar, it's just a different mindset where they're looking to take out the heroes that could roam in and then gank the SF. Snowball and Fissure, two good things for doing that. And they didn't have first pick coming into the second phase, so it's understandable that they do ban out the Earthshaker. PL is going to be removed as well, so they're assuming that iDEAL... I think it was actually iDEAL yesterday that did this. I'm going to double-check with their games. They did it up against XCTN, I believe, in the game I cast of theirs.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, they didn't. They ran a Razor mid, a safe lane Queen of Pain, and an offlane Axe, but that was a very specific scenario because a lot of the offlanes were banned out. And they ran the Axe up against the Broodmother. So it was a bit of this, like, lane switching, actually. I think at that point, too, they actually put the Queen of Pain to the off lane and the Axe to the safe lane because the Brood was playing the off. Hey, the memory's working today. What a brilliant
Radiant
thing.
Team
yeah. So, I can understand now with the PL ban out, maybe they're thinking about something else. The Gyro is not that bad at cleaning up the PL. The Winter Wyvern's also quite good at controlling the PL if they can find the real one. Darkseid doesn't mind being in a lane up against PL. It's a little bit problematic with harassment, but at the same time, he's not going to chase you. You need to get like a lot of RNG with the Doppelganger to be put in the right position to keep chasing after the Darkseer. Phantom Rush will help you with that, but it's not something you're going to say, this is how I'm going to kill the Darkseer. Wow. Like her on the team fight, why don't you? Song of the Siren into cooldown, Vac Wall, and then Winter's Curse. If they hit this combo, it doesn't matter what point of the game we're at. iDEAL are dead. Like that's just going to be the reality of the situation. Oh, okay. By the way, please definitely do share the live stream. I understand that Dota 2 Lounge has failed on the adding today. So if you would like, let everyone know that this live stream is up and running. Right now, they've just got 3 Russian live streams listed. But get on there, share it out with everyone you've got. That we are, in fact, live streaming out some Southeast Asian Dota.
5 seconds remaining.
So Spirit Breaker pickup. Well, you got some good charge, you've still got Winter's Curse. You've got Nargon Net, not the greatest control on the Spirit Breaker, and you've got Darkseer Vac. They're the 3 things that can interrupt him when he's charging in. In the early stages, that's going to be nothing, which means Signature Trust need a really solid mid laner. This has got to be a support Naga unless they're running like Varda style Gyro mid. But doing that up against an SF is a little odd. In fact, very odd. So the Animage ban out.
10 seconds remaining.
Maybe they are thinking about running this Naga as a core. You could try the Naga remaining in the mid lane. Combine it up with some like early Wyvern harass.
Reserve.
Just once you get level 2 on Naga, then you it's a little too easy to gank the Naga in the mid in the early stages with the SP and the Lion. Like it wouldn't take much a committal of smoke from the Lion or just a good angled charge in from the Spirit Breaker. Like, it wouldn't take that much for iDEAL to get the upper hand here. And I'm still liking iDEAL's team fight a lot more. They got good burst damage combos with great lockdown control. And control that can go through magic immunity, too.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Dragon Knight.
Omni
Knight.
Aha! It is a time for the knights. The Dark Knight. Alright, so the team fight is still insanely strong for Signature Trust. The issue they're going to have is really actually with the Omni Knight. The repelled Spirit Breaker charging in. Once he's got his level 6 too, you're going to be able just to, just purify him when he's sitting right on top of the target. He never strikes in. You're not going to go anywhere, and then the purification will hit you as well. That's a lot of damage just coming in from that combination. And you can get away almost with running dual. Actually, it'll be iffy to run a dual offlane. I've kind of become a fan of it, and I blame X Musica for that too. Primarily just because he showed me just how strong you can get a lane with a Spirit Breaker with a +1. That was, you kind of always knew there was some good power coming out from that, but I didn't realize that it could be that powerful. If you time your rotations really well too, that power shifts really easily. So, I'm liking the iDEAL lineup. The Omni Knight's always one of those random picks. Like, you're never 100% certain the Omni Knight is going to work for your team. In this case, the Guardian Angel, like, that's Like, you block all the physical damage coming out from Signature Trust, and the magical really isn't that amazing. You turn that on, and a mistimed flat cannon could basically mean that most of the damage which is done by Signature Trust doesn't exist. Like, you've still got your Iron Shell double burn damage, you've got Winter's Curse, but if you've turned on the ulti, then you're gonna be fine. And the Naga's Riptide, the Dragon Breed Fire, that's not enough to bring down big tanky heroes, especially when they're getting healed by the Omni Knight as well. Almost saying right now that Omni Knight has to die. So at the start, when they're looking for the Initiation Signature Trust, they have to, like, Song of the Siren and then make sure they're in range for the Dragon Tail to connect on the Omni Knight. So he is stunned up when he comes out of the Song of the Siren. That's kind of got to happen for Signature Trust to get that teamfight combo I was talking about. For now, they're establishing jungle dominance. Another one of those things to lock down when it comes to the Shadow Fiend. You're going to be very inventive with your wards when you do it this aggressively, though. As you've seen the Queen of Pain just pinging out this area. Now, either you cut the tree... Okay, that's not inventive at all. That's just one of the most obvious wards ever. You can throw a sentry down the bag here, and you'll take it out. Normally, you throw that anyway, because then you'll take out anything in the trees or anything up on the cliffside. Ideal's not going to let him have this rune. The Iron Shell's on the Naga Siren. Naga's going to turn in for a Riptide. Burn a little bit into the Spirit Breaker as they contest for the rune. As now, well, nice double stun from the Lion. The charge, a point blank range one to the Naga Siren, but then he's got no way out of this. And with the Wyvern, the Arctic Fern tries to slow everyone down. The Spirit Breaker will not be surviving this one. That's one Razor. Maybe he does. The Purification comes in time to a follow-up stun. And QQ finds himself in too deep near the Ancients. And with the Razor still coming out from the SF, he has enough damage combining with the Lion's attack that the Darkseer will end up falling. And SF, however, burnt every bit of mana he had to have that fight. So did the Omni Knight. He is bone dry with one Tango. That's all he's got on himself. But still, first blood. Claimed goes to a Lion. He's managed to pick up some boots, and this will be new sentry wards or something else along those lines. Not really the fight that Signature Trust was searching for, and you can't blame him for an early fight. Like, with Iron Shell, with the Arctic Burn, the ability to actually have, like, Riptide hitting on a couple of heroes at the very early stages. TK's Breathe Fire, even, is a nice little, like, area effect damage. Then you got Rocket Barrage. Like, you're never gonna say no to a Gyro having a level 1 fight when he's got 2 or 3 Rocket Barrages he can dish out during the middle of an engagement. So, yeah, it seems to Trust to be a little bit sad about this, but now we go into the laning phase and we'll see just how much presence Ideal has. They got the Spirit Breaker on the offlane, but he only brought consumables. So, I suppose the damage with it, well, it's only 41 damage coming out from a Wyvern, it's not really enough to make him worry too much. I think they were tossing up, actually, ensnaring on the Queen of Pain. Doesn't make as much sense. If they can catch up the Lion, they'll go for that. But Lion just needs to impel once, and that gank is over. And then Queen can turn around. She doesn't have a scream. It's just Shadow Strike and Blink for now. Oh, Wyvern is such a dick. Pushing the Spirit Breaker as far out of the lane as possible. He wants to make sure the Spirit Breaker never finds levels. It's actually not that bad. The SB's charging up to the top, trying to keep the vision here, and then Lion gets the perfect stun. This should actually be another kill right now. Omni Knight's just gonna walk in behind him and just punch him. That's all he's gotta do. Combining it with the Queen of Pain, Ideal will now take a second kill. And it's the Darkseer once again. That's not as bad for Signature Trust. Obviously, Ideal getting 2 kills is never the greatest thing in the world for them. But it's the fact that Darkseer actually has a second option. Like, he's got 2 levels up in Iron Shell already. So he's always going to be able to farm up inside the lane. But what makes it more interesting is... Yeah, she just screwed the pull. There's a little... Oh no, that's a pick for the Wyvern saying the SP is charging down the bottom lane. He is going for the Gyrocopter, but he doesn't want to complete that. He'll have to pull up just before the end. Yep. Yeah, but what makes it not so bad for the Darkseer? Once he got Sol Ring, he's still going to find his farm. The Iron Shell Harassment is still burning through consumables on this safe lane. That's why the bottle has to be here for TNT. He's got no other choice. And between Toy and TNT both running bottles, this courier is just going to get absolutely exhausted. And there's going to be no time for little off-lane spirit breakers.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
So where's our rotation going to come? Looks like DK, he's only here for the rune. Kind of feel like Naga Siren's only here to make sure he can get that rune as well. Which is exactly what happens. This Darkseer still needs to get to his Soul Ring. He doesn't have never-ending Iron Shells, which is something he would love to have. But this Gyro Farm is still really, really good. The stacks inside the jungle aren't that terrific. Actually, as I say that, SF, maybe that's the reason why they're not so terrific anymore, because SF's farming them up. He's got one more raise if he wants to use it. Looks like Toy's going to hold on to it. Because that will allow him to farm this up a little bit quicker. He's only got one.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And he may need to be purified if he's going to farm anything more. I'm going to send the bottle back. So Omni Knight gets to soak up the experience in the mid. But this just flags the timing. Oh, hello. Yotu's not going to probably survive. Oh, actually, he will. Underneath the tower with the creep wave turning around. Yep. It is quite safe underneath that tier 1 tower. Yeah, but this SF, wait, he's actually farming up the pull point. Way to screw with momentum. It's the easier cam for him to farm up because the others have been stacked. So he can't really do the other ones, like without that purification or without the bottle charges. So he's just trying to be as efficient as he possibly can. They probably weren't going to like pull it anyway. They might have been looking for a stack. Lion's going to soak up some of this experience now. The SF just wants the money. He doesn't want anything else. So the Lion can get closer towards that level 6 so they can get Finger of Death online. The Toy's burnt through everything he's got. He'll have to go back to base now. Just ferrying that bottle back and forth is not going to do it anymore. So he'll go back to base and then TP back to lane. There's still a lot of experience for him to gain. But because he's been able to have some really good stacks inside the jungle, he is ahead of the DK. But you also check out DK's jungle, and I'm looking at a quad stack now. Prepared by the Wyvern. This will be more than likely for this guy here. It's for the Darkseer. So you can leave the Naga Siren on the top lane to try and soak up as much of the experience as possible, and then the Darkseer flash farms inside the jungle. So you get to the point where you run what's pretty close to a semi-core in that fourth position. We've seen it a lot in the Western scene, and of course the Eastern scene as well, actually. Where you're able to farm up these Leaners and Naga Sirens, and they just become so damn powerful that you're like, well, okay, were they actually able to run like a dedicated jungler? But it's not that. It's the fact that you have an efficient jungler. They just back off at the right time, and when someone else is going for a kill, you give them the space in the lane. This Gyro, speaking of space, is feeling like he doesn't have it. It's no Observer Ward that actually saw the TP in from the SF, unless it timed out. I don't believe there's actually an Observer Ward there. We've got a fresh one behind the tower. There's a bottom lane ward, which is just watching the bottom rune anyway. So, yeah. Laquels will know SF's there as he's showing himself in the lane now. And he's asked for support. Meanwhile, actually diving on top lane. TK got a little bit of extra movement speed there in the Dragon Form and the Iron Shell. But then five heroes from iDEAL TP up to the top. If they can all get out of this one safely, which they can, that is a huge victory. Like, you make iDEAL give up on the attack on the Gyro. You get to inflict some level of damage into this tier 1 tower in the mid. Even though the charge is coming in, and, well, there's no back. Darkseer is going to search himself up after being frogged. And the Spirit Breaker didn't follow through either. No points in DGen Aura yet. QQ is going to give that one up. But iDEAL still burns a lot of money and time in the lanes. So they had to back up. Toy got a little bit lost there, in fact. But he's still a full two levels in front of the DK because of their efforts at the jungle. You have to stop this. That's why I was looking for more inventive warding coming out from Signature Trust. when they made that aggressive play, like, they knew it. They made the aggressive play into the dire jungle. And because of that, like, you should have been able to maintain control or at least flag the fact that you are concerned about the SS farming power. Is under attack. Which everyone should be, of course. But they let him have the space. Gyro is still ahead, though. For all the farm, for all the CS, which the SF has managed to achieve, Gyro is still getting nothing but lane creeps. It looks like he's not missing many of them. 59-49. What a wonderful CS score for a Gyro. Mikel's having the time of his life because he's not pressured by anything. And this SB knows he can't pressure the Gyro. If SB chases after this Gyrocopter, Gyro just lets the cooldown go, and SB's got no charge away to safety. Then it's Rocket Barrage and Flat Cannon to victory. You may not actually get the kill, but you're able to do a fair chunk of damage that he'll have to go back to base. And so I get a little bit of lag. But what Signature Trust is doing is just so good. Because what they're able to achieve here is the fact that you've got a DK, and normally this is what's meant to happen with the DK. You attack into the mid tower, it forces reactions like two TPs or another hero sitting in the tree line waiting for the team fight, while the rest of your lanes do the work. So you got the Iron Shell push happening from QQ on top to push into the tier 1 tower. Down the bottom lane, you've got the Gyrocopter going to work. Is under attack. Just continuously farming up as well. And iDEAL are being forced into areas of the map which they do not want to be. Now, this Gyro is coming up to the helm with the Dominator, and he may be really sad to have done this. Because they're going to initiate. Commit Sonic Wave, and Lakels will pop. They're still not really that heavy of a commitment. You want to commit Sonic Wave anyway to find yourself a kill. And a kill the safe laner is worth it. More than worth it. But you lose your tier 1 tower on the top lane. That's the other bit of a downside. The DK came up to help with that. And now they've got to try and defend their mid tower, while the bottom tower is also being pressured. Dark Creep Wave doesn't have long to live because of the tower attacks. And Signature aren't really in a position where they want to contest them in a team fight properly yet. Not until Naga's got Song of the Siren, so you need the level 6 over on Boombell. But still, iDEAL's going to give them the space to get that. So Lakel's back to the farm game. My pro is able just to hold the mid. And in 26 seconds, when the Dragon Form's back off cooldown, you'll be looking at him pressuring that tower again. And the Queen of Pain's already moving in for this. So is the Lion. So is the Omni Knight. So they're very prepared for any kind of pressure onto the tower. Is she gonna smoke up? Just an Naga Illusion coming in, so obviously not gonna break the smoke. I don't know if the Observer Vault was actually scouting that, because right now it looks like they're baiting with my pro. That circle being drawn up by the Lion. I don't know really what that's for. It's like, should we be looking at this general vicinity? The smoke's gonna break now. And we're looking at Signature Trust getting themselves into a position where they now smoke. And they found a perfect target. The Omni Knight moving forward, and they're going to surge in the Naga Siren. They still allow for the ensnare. There's still no level 6 over on that Naga Siren. So they still don't have Song of the Siren. I don't know if they've actually scouted out the fact he put that Observer Ward down. If they did, they want to get rid of that as soon as possible. TP down the bottom lane. It's a Haste Rune DK for the cooldown as well! Omni Knight! Very early controlled. Now the Shadow Fiend ensnared up for the moment. The Finger of Death's going to ensure the kill over on the DK, and the Sonic Wave spills beautifully over Signature Trust. QQ as well as Lakel's in trouble. They're going to cold embrace Lakel's, but the raised damage, the magical damage is still there, which is able to penetrate that cold embrace. So it's 5-1 for iDEAL. The Signature Trust trying to force the issue, and this time around, iDEAL's TP's in. They do find the team, and they do find the kill. Noki may have been popped very early on, but then that gave so much overconfidence to Signature Trust, you lost your two big cores, your Gyro and your DK. DK, you had a Haste Rune too, he shouldn't have been controlled. But when you got burst damage like Finger of Death coming out from Yotu, something needed to be done. Now the next teamfight's gonna be even more difficult with the full mech completed over on Toy. He'll keep his flash farming going, and he's now 1,000 net worth in front of the gyro. And iDEAL just weighed that one perfectly. I say waited it, they didn't really wait it, they were looking for it every time sign.trust were pressuring. But they did use their combo though, so Finger of Death's down, Sonic Wave is down for a little bit, Requiem of Souls was also expended. Looks like Signature are in no real position where they feel like they can push. TP in from the Wyvern is not going to be enough, he needs that Witch's Curse. Like, they actually went into a fight without using Song of the Siren or having Winter's Curse available. I'd already started to like add question marks above heads. Do you accept this quest? No, I'm too low level for this. Just in case they had any ideas about studying into Toy. The Omni Knight with a quick repel. And the Queen of Pain adds pressure on the top lane, which means someone's gonna move up here from sign.trust. A quick TP up. They're also probably going to realize too that this observer wall is down. So this small little range creep, the traitor of the dire side, is going to have some level of issue. Because you'll never be able to stack this camp again. Until they get rid of that ward. And we're actually going to go for a Shadowblade build from the DK. I was actually wondering if Blink Dagger might be the better option here. Primarily because you can still be charged, and well, I suppose the charge is going to go on no matter what, if you go Blink or Shadow Blade. But Shadow Blade at least lets you go invis. But once you get the initial stun from the Spirit Breaker, you can purify, you can, like, you got AoE damage, AoE stun, aka, what's the line stun, but it's still a stun. And Sonic Wave, like, all you need to do is get the general position of him, and then you can pop everything else. There you go. Push it back. And that control time lasts so long. Even if he was invis, it wouldn't matter. So the DK will drop down to the fourth net worth on the board. Pushing the Queen of Pain up by another 500 or 600 gold. Toy trying to push QQ back. They've both got their mechs now up and running. Issue for SF is he doesn't really have a lot of mana to use this mech. It's always one of those times where you look at the SF and you wonder, like, okay, he's like, can you TP into the mid and refresh my bottle, I think is what's being asked right now, the Spirit Breaker. So he gets to farm up the mid lane. Or is he going to get the 16-minute rune? Okay, he's going to get the 16-minute rune. And it's a double damage rune too. Very nice. Radiant's top, but it's always looking at the mana cost. So you pop off your three razors. So you burn 225 mana already. Then you try and go in for your Requiem of Souls. So you're already cracking 400 out of the 650 mana pool. And normally you want to fire off multiple razors during a fight if you can survive long enough. And then you got your mech charge, which also costs a hell of a lot more. That's... that was not required. They were worried she's going to blink away. So I can understand the concern. But they better get a tier 1 tower directly after and even inflict some damage to the tier 2 tower for this kill. Fortification's gonna slow them down, and you've already got the push coming in from the bot lane. So if they're fast enough, they can just go for a straight trade-off for a tier 1 tower, even though they lost the quap. Winter's Curse being put on cooldown, Dragon Form gonna wear off in a moment. Yeah, that's what they have to do. They have to push into the tier 2 tower to make this worth it. When you commit a big ulti like that, and you see iDEAL going for the trade-off, need to get something in. You probably won't finish off this tier 2 tower, and if you overstay your welcome, you're probably going to end up losing heroes as well. This is one of those, like, Song of the Siren into cooldown moments, but then you got no Dragon Form, you got no Winter's Curse. You do have a Iron Shell Vac Wall combo, which you could use, but you want to get the rest of iDEAL away from the tower, or have SF do this. Walks in, he's already tricked the mech, but cooldown's going to keep the rest of iDEAL out of Naga Siren. That should give me the finger on him, but then the Blink Sonic Wave Scream takes out the Darkseer as well. Lakel's controlled for the moment by his own teammate. That's the Winter's Curse. Another Winter's Curse. The Cold Embrace holding him there. Actually hurts him more than it helps him because he was not going to survive through that. And if iDEAL's proven one thing, they've still got magical damage even when you do Cold Embrace. It is not a saving mechanism. So now 9-2. iDEAL looking strong and sign.trust Couple of hiccups along the way. iDEAL still need to get more than one tier 1 tower, but that shouldn't be difficult now. This SF's getting to a point where no one will be able to contest him. Even when he is the first man in, they still can't find the kill. Omino didn't even use Guardian Angel at this point. It's just there. Purify, repel. I mean, he don't have enough mana for it. That's another issue for him, because he didn't build into Arcane Boots. Another Fresh Observer Water stop the pull. So he didn't build into Arcane Boots. We're looking at another hero who has mana issues. Purify twice, you burn 280 out of 377. Which means you can purify twice and you can repel twice and then you're out. You have to rely on your bottle charges, which isn't instant enough when you, it's gonna stack. It's not instant enough during a team fight. Oh, they're moving up, they're trying to actually stop Toy, but Toy, he's repelled up at the moment, which means they cannot look for the stun. You can take the triple stack, but keeping the SF alive at this point in the game is so much more valuable. Where are you headed, SB? Bottom lane, just to farm. It's kind of funny when we saw the SBs from yesterday. I don't remember exactly who it was. It was SCT who were playing it yesterday. Yeah, it was 2D. 2D was playing the SB yesterday. And with his start, like at one point he got a hand of minus 19 minutes in, and he had even a better quarterfinal, and he had it at 13 minutes or something along those lines. It was crazy good. But it was this attack speed, and you're like, okay, well, attack speed, you get a couple levels, it's okay. It's cool. But then you realize, like, 5-10 minutes later, he had so many core items that he was almost stronger than any other hero in the opposition. Just because of the way he was moving across the map, getting involved in fights, so much money coming in, be it share gold or whatever. It was just really smart. So if Signature Trust and Space Creator do actually get through, I mean iDEAL and Space Creator get through, then we could be looking at a contest just to get the Spirit Breaker pick up in their way. Roshan going down very quickly. This double damage rune is such a critical thing right now. It allows iDEAL to finish Roshan before Signature Trust arrive. They just need an extra 5 seconds. For Boom Bell to get close enough, they can just go to the Song of the Siren, which he should probably be doing right now. He's not worried about it. Everyone's gonna back up. Too much farm to be had on bottom lane. Once you've already got an Aegis Immortal on the back of the SF, don't really want to try your luck against him. Fighting into any team with an Aegis Immortal, you only want to do if you know you've got the upper hand in the game. I guess that Shadow Blade's here for the DK, but there's no bite to this DK. Like, he comes through and he wants a Dragon Tail. It's a level 1 Dragon Tail stun, so he's got 2.5 seconds and 25 damage from that. The Breathe Fire is kind of like the only other thing he's got. Like, the Dragon Blood will keep him alive a little bit longer during the fight, so sure. But not that much longer. Like, the armor is good. The health regen is nice. But the burst magical damage, which would obviously go around the armor, is looking very good for iDEAL. And the only physical damage that you're still looking for is, like even the greater bash is magical damage, which is really freaking stupid that that's the case. But it's one of these things where the Spirit Breaker is only looking to control him. Hold him in position for one time. Queen of Pain doesn't really care about like his armor or magic resistance anyway, because she's pumping out pure damage with that Sonic Wave. So Signature Trust need to make this work. If you're picking up a Shadow Blade, you need to be hunting for kills. It's not just a, oh, I sit back and wait for a perfect moment. If you're doing that, then you got a Blink Dagger. But he also needs to keep this push game going. A pickoff on the line is not that simple. Yes, he's only got 777 life. but his resistance is there with the cloak. And if you can't, like, the stun duration won't be long enough. Because he's got hexes and impales and Dragon Knight. Doesn't really, yeah. They just bought Dust. Shadowblade counters. That's simple. But having the Blink Dagger on the line just makes that so much easier. Spirit Breaker charges in, Lion follows up. And he can keep up because he has that Blink Dagger. The Omni Knight will repel and... Okay, yep. I think Spirit Breaker realized the toy wouldn't be able to get there in time to really inflict any kind of damage. Wait, it's just gonna be Scotty. It's just gonna be Scotty. Like, my brain's waking up in the morning, I'm just like, okay, there's very little reason to get either Octarine or anything like that. Scotty makes a lot more sense. And again, like, that's the cold embrace where it doesn't work. iDEAL knew this, like, when you get such an early pickup on the Winter Wyvern, like, you have to understand that, like, your team's just gonna draft as much magical damage as they can possibly find. Because then they don't care. At least, not as much as they have to find, but just something that gets around it. So iDEAL gonna man mode this up through the mid. I don't know if there's really much things Trust can do about this. Like, we still have to remember their combo. It can still work, but you're going up against Negus the Immortal SF. So Toy is taking a decent chunk of damage right now. Radiant's middle tower. But it's not enough to really make him worry about anything. So then iDEAL just back it up. They control their lanes. They got another 50 seconds left of this Aegis the Immortal. Before it will get reclaimed. But in that time, you're farming a BKB over on the SB. The SF is very close to picking up his full Scotty. The Lion's probably going to be building into a Glimmer Cape. Which means then Signature Trust have to start looking at... Well, they actually have to start looking at getting detection. But they're not only looking into gems, they actually have to just use Sentry Wards and Dust. My pro's never going to get that one. Even with the help of QQ as well as Boom Bell, they can't control the SB long enough to kill him. Because he'll just charge away. Like, you actually need to interrupt the charge, and even then, you're having to go through almost 1800 life points. DK shows himself for a moment, and he got the charge off. Lion jumps in, stuns over on the Darkseer with the Finger of Death. They're actually isolated because of the repel of Toy. He's able to ensure the kill on the Darkseer. Like, you commit a Finger of Death, sure. But they're gonna be okay with that. Especially when this Wyvern's gonna get popped in a moment. The SB charge is coming, but he's going on a different target. He's coming after Lakels. He's already used the Rocket Barrage. And it looks like now, yep, there's your Sonic Wave. That was really all that was required to kill off the Wyvern. So, two heroes down. You don't have your Sonic Wave, you don't have your Finger of Death. So you're not looking to go high ground at this point. You want to have everything else up. But what you are really searching for is just the outer towers now. That's the safe things to grab. Another 2 minutes before Quap's gonna have her ulti, but again, in 2 minutes time, she's gonna have her Scythe of Ice. So these cooldowns, while it might be a little bit of breathing room for Trust, it's just farm time for iDEAL to get to a point where they cannot be stopped. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. And they instantly move back to keep their farm going. And this DK is getting nowhere near into his BKB. Gyrocopter at least has a little bit of damage coming in with his immunity, which is like BKB, Helm, and Demon Edge is not a bad position for a Gyro. He probably must have a little bit more farm than this, however. A Blink Dagger for the Darkseer. Okay, this has to be Hallelujah playtime. It's kind of funny though, because Darkseer doesn't really need the Blink Dagger. Like, he needs it when Song of the Sirens on cooldown, and he wants to go for the combo. But you're not really looking for the combo anyway when Song of the Siren is down. Because you need to have that either perfect setup when all of iDEAL are standing on top of each other, or is your Get Agile free card. That's what you're looking at. It's actually a Lincoln sphere for the co-op. So trying to get himself free of... Well, they actually just repel him at the start, which means it actually triggers Winter's Curse. Winter's Curse would have to break it. And that'll be all if he's repelled when Queen of Pain jumps in. But right now, the repel's been used on Toy more than anything else. So I got a feeling it's just so we can dodge out from the Dragon Tail stun. And then, yeah, this actually makes Wyvern a useless hero at this point in the game. With the hero's ideal of gotten just having that Lincoln Sphere now, he can't really attack in any of the course. If you attack the SP, it's useless because SP will just tank through it. Attack. And also has his own BKB, so does the Queen of Pain. This is...
Dire's top tower is
I don't want to say it's over, but iDEAL are in the perfect position. This golden experience graph doesn't really show enough. Like, if we're looking for the swing, like, if we're going to actually draw ourselves a little bit of a swing bar, it's like, it's not in the middle. Like, this is iDEAL side. Like, they control this much of the off the graph. Maybe even a little bit more than that. This is just one very tough game. You're not getting anything else really out from the Naga apart from Song and Rip. But the Glimmer Cape might be able to help. Actually, the Glimmer Cape doesn't help at all because they already put a gem over an iDEAL, which is in the hands of the S... Well, okay, was in the hands of the SF. Now they're going to give it to the Queen of Pain. I'm fine with both. Queen of Pain is actually probably a better target to have it on. She's going to be moving with the front lines, so it makes a lot of sense. Where are you going, QQ? Surge your way to safety. It is nighttime, so the vision is very restricted. I'm hearing that charge is over on Lakels. They're coming in. Toy's going to show himself. And with those actually Scotty attacks, QQ slowed down, but they're repelled. The BKB still there from Lakels. Going to trigger off the call down. He's looking for the attack. The Song of the Siren had to turn off, and then Omni Knight ulti turns on. The damage. The Winter's Curse doesn't even do enough. Naga Siren getting raised to death. They blink up for the stun. The Wyvern's going to get obliterated. iDEAL actually got caught out. 5-man the Song of the Siren, and still they couldn't get the combo right. You started with the curse, but it just wasn't effective enough. So 3 heroes down for Signature Trust. The ultis are blown for iDEAL, like they blew everything to turn that around. But they lose nothing, and now they wait for Roshan. There's one ogre that's just scouting it out. And they know it has to come soon. Like Roshan spawns up in 10 seconds time. But that was actually the ogre of the gyrocopter. Alright, so if Noki waits, boom. There's Roshan. So SF will move down, he'll pick up the Aegis the Immortal. May as well buy himself something nice as well. If they really want to end this game now, you can even go something like a Desolator. If you're just looking for something for right now. Because by having that, you're just able to rip through the DK's armor. You could also just rip through tower armor. But he doesn't need to. Might limit him a little bit more for the later game, so he can just build into something a little bit stronger. There's no evasions, like we're not looking at Solar Crest, we're looking at Butterfly. So there's no, like, urging need to get a Monkey King bar. Speaking of that, there is one on the Gyrocopter. This damage output from the gyro is still not scary enough.
Top tower is under attack.
iDEAL's got too much life. If the damage the gyro does, most of it will be repaired by the mech. And then what other damage do you really have? And what part of that damage will just get taken out by the purification and the Guardian Angel? Yeah. Alright, there's your DK BKB. Still only a level 2 dragon form, so he doesn't have that slow frost dragon that he's searching for. And really right now, iDEAL aren't looking to force the issue. Like, they're keeping the bottom lane pressure in. Queen of Pain gave a little bit of push power. And the Spirit Breaker's probably going to charge from the top lane after he's pushed out a little bit more. And that charge... Okay, he's charging it already. He managed to get vision on the gyrocopter. Now, do they try and run in for this one? No. Spirit Breaker's just using it as a path to get down to the bot lane. And he'll cycle around behind the lane. Mid lane is still going to push a little bit nicely. And yeah, he's still going to stick around. KYT's going to stick around for this. It's not as far to charge from halfway across the map. The SF going up, almost beating that Wyvern into submission. The Razors, the second one a little bit off target, but now Lakels as well, walking to the front lines. They might get the Sun Over on the Queen of Pain, but SF man-moding in the back. The SB charging in, Lakels is down. The Sonic Wave did its work before the Song of the Sun even came off. They're all down. This game is over. Signature Trust, it was only a matter of time before iDEAL would break their spirits, and there's the GG call. 3-2-1. I'm sorry, the dream is not real. It is not 3-2-2. They're just one short of an iota. But a strong game. A strong, strong game coming out from iDEAL. Quality play, quality Dota. And they're into the grand finals with a guaranteed 500 USD courtesy of Corsair. We'll be going into our next game. The lobby's already hosted up, so we should have a short break and we'll be back here as we'll have the Australians. The Australians. It is the Singapore Rejects versus SCT, which is kind of funny because half of these guys in the Australian team actually moved from Singapore to Australia, and there's two Singaporeans in it as well. So this is a Singaporean-Australian event coming up next. Stay tuned.